Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today I'm going to make a, I think it will be a faster review of another Chinese pen. This pen is the Moonman 80S, and I already reviewed the Moonman 80 and Moonman 80 Mini. So this is somehow similar. I'm just going to show you the differences to make a writing sample, and I think that's it. So, first of all, let's see the box. As you can see, it has this cardboard box that is just a simple sleeve, and inside you have the pen that is stuck here by an elastic, and there is nothing beneath this cardboard pen tray. So I'll take the pen out and let's look at the details. First of all, this is a quite cheap Chinese pen. It is an inexpensive pen, around 6-7 euros. It is made of plastic. It is a black plastic, although it's not a deep black, real black, in my opinion. Just let me show it next to a Parker 45, which is the pen that is similar. Okay, I'll have to. Oh, sorry. Okay, I don't really find much difference, but believe me, this is more on the grayish side, although it seems the otherwise, but it's not. Okay, so the pen is very similar to a Parker 45, but let's see the differences. It has the top of the cap made of metal. It has the clip, which is a arrow clip, but without the feathers here on the top of the clip. On the cap band, which is very large, it says Moonman. There's no indication of the 80, and then there is this tassie on the end of the barrel, made of metal also. Then this pen clicks on place and it has a nib that is the same nib as the Parker 45, and it is overall the same construction, and inside it takes cartridges or converter, and it also can take Parker converter because all parts are interchangeable. But all the parts really are interchangeable. That's the big question. No, not, sorry, not all the parts are interchangeable. This pen is like the Moonman Mini that I showed you. Let me put this down here, it's easier. This is more similar to the Moonman 80 Mini, which is the same pen, just with a shorter barrel. And this pen has one big difference, which is the cap mechanism. I'll take this one out. This is the Moonman 80, which is a very nice pen, similar to this one, but the cap is a slip fit cap, and this cap can be exchanged with any Parker 45 cap. This one cannot because it clicks on place. It has a different click sealing mechanism, and if you try to put a Moonman 80 cap on this, it fits, but not completely, as you can see. And if you put the Moonman 80S on Moonman 80, it doesn't secure at all. So I think this was. I don't want to be rude with this, but this is quite stupid. If you have a pen that is interchangeable with a more vintagey pen that is quite nice, why don't you make the pen that is fully compatible? Maybe you'll get a vintage Parker 45, for example, this one that had no cap. And if you had the cap of this one, you could put in this, or the ring here or something else. In this one, it will not be compatible because the clicking mechanism, the closing mechanism is not the same. It is a click on place. I find this quite stupid. Otherwise, it is quite similar to a Parker 45 with a steel nib, very well balanced pen on the slimmer side, but it is not that slim here on the section. It usually posts really well and deeply, and this is one of the few pens that I can really use posted because it really posts very, very deeply, which is quite nice. This happens with all the Parker 45 pens, and it is a really nice feature. So this pen has the same writing experience as the Parker 45. It is a copy. Many people don't like it for being a copy, but I don't, in my ethics, I don't find it that so wrong, this one being a copy of the Parker 45. And as you can see, there are some other copies around. These pens are not copies, they are customized pens by Kulok in Argentina, but this one is a fake, is a copy of a Parker 45. As you can see, it is, I will not be able to show you, I think it is a Perix pen. This one is a Medico, which is an Indian copy of a Parker 45. This is another copy. This is the brand is Crest, which is very similar also. So there have been always lots of copies. I believe since Parker discontinued Parker 45, I don't find it to be so bad to have copies of a Parker, of a pen that is discontinued now, because it allows you to have the same experience with a brand new pen instead of getting a vintage one that could be quite cheap, but sometimes they are not. I have to say that if they are cheap, and because I like Parker 45 so much, I always buy any Parker 45 that I find for around 5 euros, and sometimes they do appear for 5 euros, 10 euros, 15 euros. When I see one cheap one, I buy it, because I think it is a shame to have these pens being thrown away, like if they were no used. This one is a good replica, but why not being a full replica, more like the Moonman 80? So if you had to choose, if I had to choose now, I wouldn't have this Moonman 80S, but yes, I would have the Moonman 80, which is much nicer. Really, in my opinion, I would not have any of these to use, because I have Parker 45s and I can get them, but not everyone can get them, not everyone have flea markets around, so this may be a solution. I like to have them because I collect Parker 45s and their copies and replicas and forgeries, so for me it makes sense to have them, even if they are not perfect. So this is what I had to talk about the pen. I think the review is a kind of a different review, and now I'll just make the writing sample. Take this pen case away. And the box fell on the floor. Empty box, no problem. And so here we have the Moonman 80S in black. There are several colors. It is similar to the Parker 45, but just to have the size checked with the Parker Centennial Fold and the Lamy All Star. As you can see, it is a slimmer pen and a little more short. The nib is a semi-hooded nib, which makes it a very short nib, even in comparison with the All-Star, the Lamy All-Star. As you can see, a very small nib. But usually Parker 45s have great nibs in my opinion, although they may be a little bit hard to use because some of them have sweet spots, some very small sweet spots. So let's look at this one and how it writes. And because it has been uncapped, let's see if it writes right away. So this is the, and it writes Moonman 80S black. And the nib of this is a fine or an extra fine. And let me focus better here. The paper is the usual Rhodia dot pad, nice Rhodia paper, and the ink is one of my favorite. The it skipped because I rotated the nib, sorry. It is the Parker Quink green, very nice green. I really like it. So this pen, it has a quite dry nib in my opinion. The nib is hard. You can try to have some line variation, but you really can't. If you spread the tines, all you'll have is a bigger ink flow, not really an increase on line width. And about writing upside down, it writes also well, but there is not that much difference in the line. So, about the ink flow, it is a drier pen, but it writes and it keeps up with the pace. So, if you want to have a nice pen to write with every day, maybe in classes or meetings to take some notes, this is a classy pen, as you can see, but very classy pen, very easy to use. They take Parker cartridges, so they are compatible with readily available cartridges anywhere. They can take up ink bottle, but if you can, go for a real Parker 45. If you can't, go for the Moonman 80. And if you like really shorter pens, you may go to the Moonman 80 Mini, which is just like that, and it has the same annoying closing mechanism. But at least you're buying it because it's shorter. In my opinion, there's no sense in buying this larger pen just with a different clicking mechanism. What is the advantage? I'm not sure. Just to have a very inexpensive pen. So, thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video, even if you didn't like the pen. So, if you liked the video, even if you don't like the pen, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you liked or didn't like the pen, please add some comments below on the comment section and say what you think about this. And if you enjoy our videos, please subscribe our YouTube channel and keep coming for more videos like these or some other. So, until next time, bye.